Dear children, welcome back to the English class. In this unit, The Ray of Hope, you have learned the short story Vanga and the poem Mother to Son. Vanga was an orphan who faced a lot of difficulties and forced to work as an apprentice to a shoemaker. In Mother to Son, we saw a mother's care and advice to his son. The short story Vanga and Mother to Son emphasize that mother's love and care are very important in life. Now, let's watch this video. What do you understand from this video? We understand that love, care, and affection can bring about wonderful changes in one's life. Yet, there are people who are denied of these things. Here is a story of an unfortunate boy who is deprived of parental love and care. The Castaway by Rabindranath Tagore. Have you heard about Rabindranath Tagore? Yes. He was the first Indian to win the Nobel Prize in Literature. He was also the author and composer of Indian National Anthem. Watch this video.
Rabindranath Tagore was born on 7th May 1861 at Calcutta in British India. He was known in many sobriquets: Gurudev, Kaviguru, and Vishwakavi. He reshaped the Bengali literature and music as well as the modern art. In 1931, he became the first Indian and first non-European to receive the Nobel Prize for Literature. The profoundly sensitive, fresh and beautiful verse of Gitanjali brought him the Nobel Prize. King George V awarded knighthood to Tagore in his 1915 birthday honors, but Tagore denounced it after the 1919 Jallianwala Bagh massacre. Tagore wrote poetry as an 8-year-old boy. At the age of 16, he released his first substantial poems under the pseudonym Bhanu Simha. 1877 onwards, he wrote his short stories and dramas published under his real name. As a humanist, universalist, internationalist, he denounced the British Raj and advocated independence from Britain. As an exponent of the Bengali Renaissance, he advanced a vast canon that comprised paintings, sketches, doodles and poetry, novels, essays, short stories, travelogues, dramas, and thousands of songs. His legacy also endures in the institution he founded Vishwabharati University. In 1901, Tagore moved to Shantiniketan to found an ashram with a prayer hall, an experimental school, groves of trees, gardens, and a library. Gitanjali, Gora, Garbhaya are his best-known works. His compositions were chosen by two nations as national anthems, India's Janaganamana and Bangladesh Amar Sona Bangla. The inspiration for the composition of Sri Lankan national anthem was his work. He passed away on 7th August 1941 at the age of 80.
Have you watched it? Yes. Now, write a profile of Rabindranath Tagore using the hints given here. Born 7th May 1861. Place of birth, Calcutta, India. Famous as poet, short story writer, musician, educationist, and philosopher. Nationality, Indian. Notable works, Gitanjali, Kabuliwala, The Postmaster, The Broken Nest. Achievement, the first non-European to win the Nobel Prize for Literature. Died 7th August 1941. Now, let's read the story of the unfortunate boy. Read the first three paragraphs. The battle of gods and demons began in the evening. The roaring storm, the pouring rain, the burgeoning thunder and lightning and the black clouds all took their part. The Ganges was furious, and one could hear nature's screams, sighs, groans everywhere. In one of the riverside houses of Chandernagar, an endless verbal battle was going on between Sharad and his wife Kiran about her staying in the house. Kiran fell seriously ill, making everyone in her native village terribly anxious. The whole village advocated for a change necessary for her and to be taken to her own home. But Sharad and his mother gave more importance to their darling than the wisdom of the village. The doctor also thinks that you should stay here for a few more days to return home strong again. Oh, your doctor knows everything. Let him know that a recovered person never needs further medicated recovery. I can go home right now. Now you know that all sorts of illness have eluded from here. Now, I suppose everyone here would be perfectly well in this tomb. Sharad looked at her face. She still appeared to be very weak. His heart sank at the thought of how narrowly she had escaped death. Kiran had enjoyed being with the villagers, steaming with fun. But here in the riverside, she could not tolerate with the heavy burden of doing nothing. That was the point of discussion. He lost his spirit when she suddenly stopped responding and turned her head away. Dear children, who are the main characters mentioned in this story? Sharad and his wife Kiran. Why were the villagers anxious about Kiran? Yes, because Kiran had fallen seriously ill. Now you read the paragraph once again. While reading, write the unfamiliar words in your വൊക്കാബുലറി ബുക്ക്. Children, have you finished reading? Yes. What really is the battle of gods and demons mentioned here? The battle of gods and demons mentioned here is the roaring storm, the pouring rain, the burgeoning thunder and lightning. ശക്തമായ കൊടുങ്കാറ്റും പേമാരിയും ഘോരമായ ഇടിമുഴക്കവും ഭയാനകമായ മിന്നൽപ്പിണറുമെല്ലാം യുദ്ധസമാനമായ അന്തരീക്ഷം സൃഷ്ടിച്ചു. ഇതാണ് ബാറ്റിൽ ഓഫ് ഗോഡ്സ് ആൻഡ് ഡീമൻസ് എന്നതുകൊണ്ട് ഉദ്ദേശിക്കുന്നത്. Burgeoning thunder. What does burgeoning mean? Burgeoning means to hit someone with heavy objects. Here it means very powerful thunder. The Ganges was furious because of the heavy rain. What does the writer mean by the Ganges was furious? Furious means angry. So the Ganges was furious means Ganges was very violent. Ganga Nadi prakshubdhamayirunnu. Now let us move on to the second paragraph. Where did Sharath and his wife live? They live in one of the riverside houses of Chandernagar. What was going on there between Sharath and his wife? An endless verbal battle. Heated arguments. Hot exchange of words. Vaakpori. What was the verbal battle about? The verbal battle was about Kiran staying in the house. Kiran was seriously ill. The whole villagers wanted her to be taken to her own house. But Sharath and his mother wanted her to stay in their house. What idea do you get about Kiran from this incident? We understand that everyone loved Kiran very much. Now let us move on to the next paragraph. The line, a recovered person never needs further recovery. What does Kiran mean by that? Kiran means that she has recovered from her illness. So she does not have to stay there for further treatment. What made Sharath's heart sink? Or what made Sharath feel sad? The thought of how narrowly Kiran had escaped from death. Dear children, now read the third paragraph and say what you understand about Kiran. Yes, Kiran had enjoyed the company of the villagers. She was fond of society and amusement. She has nothing to do there, and she did not like to be inactive.
ഗ്രാമവാസികളുമായുള്ള സൗഹൃദം കിരണിന് ഏറെ ഇഷ്ടമായിരുന്നു. സമൂഹവും വിനോദവും കിരണിന് പ്രിയപ്പെട്ടതായിരുന്നു. അലസമായിരിക്കുന്നത് കിരണിന് ഒട്ടും ഇഷ്ടമായിരുന്നില്ല.
Which sentence in this paragraph suggests that she did not like to be inactive? Yes, she could not tolerate with the heavy burden of doing nothing. Children, now see the first paragraph once again. Here you can see one word highlighted. Which is that word? The burgeoning thunder. You know the meaning of the word. Let's see the function of the word burgeoning. The word burgeoning here is used as an adjective. It modifies the noun that follows it. Thunder. So we understand that ing form of the word can be used as an adjective. Which are the other adjectives ending in ing in this paragraph? Yes, the pouring rain and the roaring storm. Now see the highlighted word in this paragraph. Recovered person. The word recovered modifies the noun person. So it also does the function of an adjective. So we understand that the past participle form of the verb can also function as an adjective. There is one more adjective in this type in this paragraph, which is that, yes, medicated recovery. Children, now you have understood that the ing form of the verb can function as an adjective and the past participle form of the verb can also function as an adjective.
വെർബിൻ്റെ ing ഫോമും അതുപോലെ പാസ്റ്റ് പാർട്ടിസിപ്പിൾ ഫോമും ചില സന്ദർഭങ്ങളിൽ അഡ്ജക്റ്റീവായി ഫങ്ഷൻ ചെയ്യാറുണ്ട്. അതായത് നൗണിനെ വിശേഷിപ്പിക്കാറുണ്ട്.
Now read the story once again and make a list of these types of adjectives. Let's watch a video and complete this conversation. Dear children, you know that the villagers wanted Kiran to be taken to her own house. But Sharat and his mother wanted her to stay with them. There is an argument between them. Who do you support? Sharat and his mother or the villagers? Justify your answer and send it to your teacher. Children, hope you could understand this part of the story. Stay tuned for the next part. Me, Pavitran Mavila, Mattanur Higher Secondary School. Goodbye.